he is the star also of some of TV's best comedy, including Outnumbered and Out Cuckoo. Please welcome the man with officially the greatest name in showbiz. It's Tiger Druhani. He comes on our first show and all you do is squirt him.
I really didn't mean to do that.
I know, but I could see as you were doing it that the trajectory was going right up there.
I do have a good trajectory. It's been commented on before. Yeah.
Tiger, I've got to say, it's awesome to meet you. Yeah. It's great that you come on the show. I was a huge fan of Outnumbered, like everybody is. And it was so good because it was sort of ad-libbed a lot, wasn't it?
Yeah, there was a heavy element of improvisation in the show.
I mean,
obviously, with a sitcom, you know, you've got to have, like any story, you've got to have a beginning, a middle, and an end. Yeah. So there was a script that we sort of didn't have to, you know, it wasn't us learning lines. It was generally the whole thing for the first few series, at least anyway, was the directors would just show us the script just before the scene and say, say these lines how you want, when you want, kind of thing.
You just have to get to a certain point and you're like, this is the point of this scene.
So if you, you know, if it was a natural saying, no, I don't want to do that, you know, just put it in your own words, because no, you know, 50-year-old man can sort of accurately, you know, write the inner sort of thought process of a young child.
No.
So that was a sort of general scripting of it.
I think we're going to see the thought process happening of the very first episode, actually. It's quite a while ago.
You'll love this.
OK.
Sorry, I can't really remember.
Oh, and he's picked up the phone to a cold cooler. Classic schoolboy error. Classic mistake, Dad.
No, I mean, obviously, yeah, I would like to pay less for my energy. But...
don't get involved, Dad. It's just stupid. They've got, you know, they call up 6 o'clock at night, every night.
I know what I'm doing. Get on with that.
No, you're so cute.
You haven't changed a bit.
I haven't changed a bit.
There's a rumour that it's coming back. There's a reunion. Please tell me it's true.
Yes. Well, it's not a rumour. It will be coming back. It was looking like it would be coming back not as a Christmas special, because Christmas specials tend to get lost amongst a mass of other Christmas specials. But it does look like it will be a special sometime around Christmas.
Fantastic. Right. I'm glad you've cleared that out for everyone, because we were all dead confused about that. Hey, listen, enough about Outnumbered. Let's talk about Cuckoo. Back for its third series, BBC Three, BBC One. I'm loving it. Are you?
Yes, I'm loving it, and I love doing it as well. It's a fantastic show to be a part of. I guess I've kind of flown the cuckoo's nest and gone from one sitcom to another. I mean, so this series, Dale has, who left at the end of last series, he's come back miraculously out of the blue, which has made us all really happy, because at the end of last series we ended up loving him.
And this is Taylor Lautner, isn't
this
it?
This is Taylor Lautner, yeah.
Yes, Lautner.
You could say Taylor Lautner, but...
that's what we say in Bolted, it's fine. Yeah. And he's in the Twilight series, so he's a huge, big megastar. I mean, what's it like working with someone from Hollywood? Does he have his own Winnebago and white tigers and things?
I mean, he's the sweetest guy. He's a really, really sweet, down-to-earth guy, you know, besides what he is. He is immaculately talented, and he, you know, if we're all working at like 2:30 in a night shoot, and someone's suddenly gone, I'm hungry. Taylor's gone. Let's just get 40 pizzas in.
He can afford it. That's why. let's take a look at you in action.
Dan, gonna look after the baby. Gonna give it its bottle and wear a pinny and be the plan we go.
Oh, shut up! I'm not even gonna mention this at work. As soon as your mother lays eyes on that baby and the old oxytocin hormone starts to flow in, all thoughts of paternity leave will exit her mind. No. I'm just going to ride this out.
Yeah, sweet plan, Dad. Now, give me 20 quid or I'll tell Mum.
Oh, Dylan. When you go to university and leave home...
yeah, what?
Nothing. It's just a wonderful thought.
It's so good. I've got to say, I watched it because I knew you were coming on this show, but if you've not seen it, can I just do an appeal to the nation to search it out on Catch Up, because it's really fantastic.
It's brilliant.
And genuinely hilarious. We've got a picture of both your screen dads here.
Okay.
We've got actual comedy giant Greg Davis there on the right.
Standing at 6'8", I believe.
6'8". He's a
really?
Monster.
He's about 6'8".
Hugh Dennis.
Wow.
Who's your favourite? Tell us now. Who's your favourite daddy, Tiger?
I'm going to go purely... this is completely unpersonally. I'm just going to go statistically, based on the fact that I've worked with Hugh for longer, that I have a better bond with
Hugh. That's mad. That's going to be a bit awkward when you're back on set, isn't it?
No, I mean, the thing is, they're both, you know, they're both completely lovely men.
Yeah, you've said it now.
You've said it. You've chosen. You've said your favourite daddy. Tiger, thank you so much for coming in to see us.
Thank you.
An absolute pleasure. Give it up for Tiger, really.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, we've covered so much TV already, but the biggest decision of the day still remains...